What's up everyone, Howard Pinsky here, taking a look at my top 5 features in the latest Photoshop update, Photoshop CC 2015. Everything from artboards to layer style adjustments, real-time content-aware healing, and a lot more. Let's go ahead and take a look. Alright, here we are in Adobe Photoshop CC 2015 with the first feature on my list, artboards. If you're currently an Illustrator user, very little explanation should be needed as artboards have been around forever. But to Photoshop-only users, this may take a little bit of time to get used to. What you're looking at now is a Photoshop document as you've known it, a single canvas that houses all the elements of your document, which has worked great, but if you needed to work on different variations of your project, there really wasn't a simple solution. There were layer comps, but it was pretty limited. Let's look at how artboards can help. When you're creating a new document in Photoshop CC 2015, in addition to traditional canvases, you can now choose to create an artboard. And Adobe has included presets for various situations, from mobile design, web design, and even specific icon sizes. Let's choose one of the web presets. At first glance, other than the label above the artboard, it may not look much different. Just like with a standard document, elements can be placed on the artboard and are confined to its boundaries. So what's the big deal? The difference is that documents are not limited to a single artboard. Instead of shuffling between multiple files, additional artboards can be created using the new artboard tool. Clicking on Add New Artboard on the options bar, I can either select one of the presets or enter a custom size. I'll keep the height the same, but enter a width of 480 pixels to help me design and plan out my mobile CSS style sheet. I can now either copy elements from the larger artboard over to the new one, or design a few from scratch. And just like before, they're all contained within the boundaries of the artboard. Working with smart objects also has its benefits. With all of your designs in one document, you'll now be able to see your changes without bouncing back and forth between your files. Simply double-click on the smart object you wish to modify and make the change. Once you save, all the duplicates will be updated across all of your artboards, no matter how many you have. Finally, artboards aren't just for new documents. If you have a project that you've been working on that you think could benefit from artboards, select the layers you wish to confine, right-click, and choose Artboards from Layers. Name it, choose a preset if you wish, and press OK. Now, if some of the original layers extended outside of the previous canvas, the artboard tool can easily resize it to perfection. And those are artboards. Again, if you haven't been an Illustrator user, it may take a little bit of time to get used to, but if you're a designer who uses Photoshop, you're definitely going to want to give it a try. The second highlight on my list are the changes to layer styles. When you first open the new layer styles dialog box, you may have a moment of confusion. Plus buttons, arrows, what is going on? In Photoshop CC 2015, you can now add multiple strokes, inner shadows, overlays, and drop shadows. This will let you get further creative with your layers without having to duplicate or place them within a group just to add more styles. Finally, the additional styles that you add can be rearranged using the new arrows at the bottom of the window. The changes to layer styles aren't a huge in-depth feature, but definitely a welcome one. My next two highlights are improvements to Content Aware and Healing. First off, Content Aware Move isn't just for moving anymore. Now in Photoshop CC 2015, when you go to relocate an object using Content Aware Move, the heal won't take place right away. Instead, Photoshop will give you the chance to transform it as well. This is perfect if you're looking to not only move an object, but also change its size to give it a new perspective. Next, on the healing front, Adobe has made some major improvements to a few of the healing tools that you use in your day-to-day work. The patch tool and the spot healing brush will now heal your images almost instantaneously, and the healing brush heals in real time. Let's take a quick look. Switching over to Photoshop CC 2014 for a moment, you'll notice that once I finish brushing with the spot healing brush, Photoshop starts the thinking process, which can take a few minutes if you're dealing with very large images. Now, switching back to CC 2015, brushing on the same area no longer makes you wait while Photoshop does its thing. It just does it. The healing brush has also received quite the update as well. In CC 2014, when you brush over top of an area you wish to heal, Photoshop doesn't start the blending process until you finish your brush stroke. But now in CC 2015, all healing is done in real time. Notice that when I'm brushing, the healing is already taking place, which allows me to see a more accurate representation of what the final product is going to look like. The final feature on my list is one that you may have seen a sneak peek of in Lightroom done by Terry White, and that is Dehaze. As you can imagine, this feature helps you remove any haze that may be present in your photo. When I first heard about this feature, I figured it would just reproduce what a few of the basic sliders would be able to accomplish, but I've actually been quite impressed with the results. So here's a photo I took while in the Eiffel Tower, and as you can tell, it's quite hazy in the distance. Now as it's a raw file, when I drag it into Photoshop, Camera Raw fires up. Now traditionally, I would start fiddling with the basic adjustments to try and reduce the haze. Drop the highlights, the shadows, the whites, increase the contrast and the clarity, and maybe even drop the exposure a touch. Well, it helped, but barely. Let's reset these adjustments and see what Dehaze can do. Hopping over to the Effects tab, you're going to see the new Dehaze slider, which is set in the middle at 0. If you had a need to, you can actually introduce haze to a photo by dragging it to the left, but we're not looking to do that. Pulling the slider to the right will start to reduce the haze and does a pretty decent job. Of course, if there's an insane amount of haze, there's only so much it'll be able to remove. And you may also notice that it's not just reducing the heavy haze, but it's also equalizing out the rest of the scene. Now with most of the haze dealt with, I can hop back into the basic adjustments to make some final tweaks. And those are my top 5 features in Photoshop CC 2015. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and if you're a Creative Cloud member, the update is available to you right now. And if you're looking to learn Photoshop from start to finish, beginner to advanced, head on over to lynda.com/Howard. I'm hooking you guys up with a 10-day completely free trial. You can watch thousands of videos from some of the best instructors all over the world, and I guarantee you, you will learn a ton, not just in Photoshop, but pretty much any application you can think of. So thanks for watching. Guys, head on over to ICEFLOWSTUDIOS.com to check out what else is new in Photoshop CC 2015, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Take care.